Hi, this is Sandhya from EQ Magazine, India's oldest and leading solar media. And today we have Mr. Nick. Mr. Nick, welcome to EQ.
Thank you very much.
Sir, can you tell us something about your company?
Okay, we are in India from last 5 years. We have made around 5 stages for our company. Currently, we are almost completed second stage and we are on third stage. We just acquire a new facility which can support up to 1000 megawatt land capacity and 250 megawatt building capacity. We have finished our second stage with almost 100 megawatt facility. Our goal is to go all other products as well, like glass, EVA, backsheet, over the next 3 to 5 years, and try to give around job 5000 plus people to near Gujarat and other area by having the different distribution network as well.
So what products or services are you exhibiting here today?
Mainly we make solar panel, range of the solar panel from 100 watt to 330 watt, which are used in solar pump, residential solar market and ground mounted systems.
So what's your upcoming plans or projects for Indian market or international market as well?
Okay, first of all, the existing market itself is very big. Like, we have 100 gigawatt target in India by 2022. So the expansion for existing product itself will take another 2 to 3 years. There are new technology is always there. Like, currently we are using 5 to 6 busbar solar panel. We are in process to make 12 busbar solar panel by end of next year. 12 busbar solar panel means every solar panel will be 12 columns in every cells, and which will help us in the small crack and also improve the production up to 5% than the normal solar cell, and it will be even cheaper than the normal solar cell. The other in that's about cell. In a glass, we are developing new glass with our existing manufacturer by having the because the India market, we experience there is a lots of dust, and that is giving some problem, means we need regular maintenance. So we are developing a new technology in a glass which will be up to 70% better than the existing glass in terms of the dust holding. So even any dust, that will be easily removed by wind as well. So that will increase the production by 10%, or which needs low maintenance. So those two major change we are hoping next 12 months.
Yeah. So do you feel the government policies supportive solar energy?
I think some recent changes, I give example, like we got a 25% safeguard duty for the overseas manufacturer. So if people are making solar panel, they have to pay, if they are importing in India, they have to pay 25%. But I think for local manufacturer, we are, because of that policy, there is a duty on us as well, and that is almost 30% duty. I explain you how, like every solar cell, like currently still India is not mature market to make solar cell. Of course, we are very mature making solar panel, and some safeguard duty was required. But in with module safeguard duty, they have also imported duty on solar cell. So still, if we buy solar cell from locally, people, there are not enough supplier, or they have their own module facility. So they are not ready to give their solar cell to other solar manufacturer. And maybe there are only handful of solar cell manufacturer in India who are not ready to supply to another 100 plus manufacturer. And so if we import from China, we still have to pay 25% duty on solar cell. Again, on a glass, there is almost 40% duty. If we import from overseas, there is only one major player in India who is making solar glass, and his price may be, as we know, only one person selling one product, he will charge definitely what he likes to charge. And there are more than 500 players who are invested their money and their dreams and help. Like, see, for me, I think I have some depth for this country because I studied here my engineering when I was 22 years old. I went in Australia to do master, and then Australian system also helped me to develop what I am today. But then still I have a depth because the teacher, the government provide free of cost. The university, it is free to me. So there is a depth for India on me, and that's why I came back. Once I got enough for me and support my family, I think I should do something for a country. But it is sometimes we feel little bit hard because, see, we invested, it's not like, of course, we invested what we have. You know, my simple policy, I never took a bank loan and not taking bank loan for my future growth as well. So it's not hurting me, but when I see the other manufacturer who took lots of money from a bank, and they have a staff, even we have a staff as well, but when and they feel like they are not getting enough support by changing the overnight policy and nobody is looking after them, maybe some big company, I'm not sure, the people who designed the policy, there is some error, or they need some more knowledge, or they should speak to more people locally to understand what are the issue affecting. Because as I explained, 25% duty on solar cell. But if I import a glass from in China, even it is cheaper than if I buy from India, 40% duty. I have to pay 40% duty. And glass and solar cell is taking almost 70% of solar panel cost. Then there are another product also, EVA, backsheet and other things, either you have to import or you have to pay higher cost in India. If you import, there is another, every product have a duty. So basically Chinese company, and also the another most benefit to Chinese company, the China company is, they are in a business from last 12 years, they are doing very good over there, their infrastructure is already paid, their machine is already paid, and the people, solar panel manufacturer in India, they have to pay for their machine, they have to pay for infrastructure, they need to give the training to the staff. If we need 50 good staff, we have to recruit 100 staff, because 50 staff, either the job is not good for them, or they are not good for the product itself. So you have to spend extra money to train 100 people and you will tune up only 50 good people. It's not only the problem of APS, it will be problem of every second manufacturer. So the training also is burden for the solar module manufacturer, and duty is very high because we are paying almost more duty than even finished product coming from China. So there is a big gap in policy design. If it will be not fixed on time, it will maybe create some issue, or it will be same situation. Still the product will come from overseas, and there will be, or as always, and made in India will be just in our dream, not in reality. Doesn't matter how much hard work we all do.
Always hope for the good time, or things will be better.
I think because by coming, like I am here from last 10 days, and I started speaking with other module manufacturers as well, and I just give them an idea, let's get together, because we should, it's not about competition, the market is very big, you know, and my perspective, like I develop many retail company in Australia who are doing number one in Australia. Like we install highest number of solar system in Australia from last 5 years. We help even government, because over there the system is little bit different. Before they change any policy or planning to change, they give 12 months and they take people's view on it. You know, business people's view, even residential people's view, and then they come up with policy. Over here, I don't have any idea. Somebody comes and speak to any of our company in last 5 years when they are making the policy.
So thank you so much. Thank you so much for being with us. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your time. And we hope you will take this message for little bit further. Yeah. And every little bit will help. And one day we will make the policy clear, and the India will be really properly made in India country.
Definitely, sir. We will do that.
And I believe the new generation have very good talent. people have dreams, people are very hardworking, and even our labor cost, our labor cost is almost 50% than China. The power facility is good, but just policy, and of course maybe people are working on policy. If that will understandable policy, then nobody can stop India to be number one in manufacturing.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for your participation. Thank you.